afternoon. Welcome. Good afternoon and welcome. My name is Don Grice. I'm organist and music director here at Central, and I'm glad you've joined us today, whether you're here in person or online. We're delighted that you have chosen to be part of this celebration of this exciting moment in the life of our church. I would like to, first of all, offer thanks to our donor, that's Dr. Panos and Debbie Kalaridis, for their generosity in donating this instrument. We can't thank them adequately, but we would like to recognize them now. Would you please stand? I would also like to thank those who contributed additional funds for related expenses and concert costs. You'll find their names in the program booklet, and we'd like to express our gratitude for those folks as well. The instrument was built by Anne Acker, who will be playing it today. She is an historic keyboard specialist living in Savannah, Georgia. She has an extensive career as a performer on piano, forte piano, harpsichord, and early organs. She is a consultant and lecturer on 18th, 19th, and early 20th century piano, and she professionally builds, appraises, restores, and decorates harpsichords and historic pianos for clients across North America and beyond. We are also pleased to welcome viola da gamba player Marcy Jean Brenner, who holds degrees in that instrument as well as harpsichord, and has a long career of performing, teaching, and recording in Europe and the USA. I would invite you to read more complete biographies for both performers in the program booklet. You will also find details about the instrument. Anne has given us extensive information about the design, construction, and materials used. It is a fascinating read, and I would encourage you to do that. For those who are observing this via live stream, you'll find a link in the description area that will take you to the program booklet. Now, please join me in welcoming our performers, Anne Acker and Marcy Brenner.
Thank you. or passions, as they would say in the Baroque time. Baroque music was very serious about evoking the feelings of the listener, and I hope our program today will carry us through from the drama, as our first piece, and like this past year, through sorrow, loss, resolution, celebrating life and faith. A couple of quick notes. You'll notice on the program that pieces are grouped with a little title. We're going to play the pieces in the groups with only the briefest of pauses. We're going to keep going to keep the affect of that section together. So if you would refrain from clapping, if you feel like clapping after we're done with the set, that's lovely. But it'd be nice if we could just keep going and keep that feeling there. And another note is that you'll notice the title on the program notes is different from the title for the concert that was put out. That is a COVID story. Originally, we were going to bring our baritone with us, and he was going to open the program with Music for a While by Henry Purcell, which is about singing how music calms and actually this terrible beast. And it's a terrible beast with hair made of hissing snakes, which you could think of as anxiety and fear, if you wish. And so that was going to be our opening, but Kyle, his wife is a school teacher, and his mother-in-law, who lives with them, is a school teacher, and Kyle decided he did not want to expose us to any risk, and this was before we were getting vaccines and we had to make the final decision. So that is our COVID story, and now let us proceed. And thank you so much for coming. This is my first concert with people in it in a year. I just had one a few weeks ago in recording, but this is the first one with people. It's lovely to see people.
Thank you. There is a whole family of viola da gamba. This is a tenor size, and this is the bass. This one has a seventh string, a very low string below the cello, but normally the viol has six strings like a guitar, and it's tuned almost like a guitar. It has frets like a guitar, except that they are not set into the fingerboard. I can move them around. In case my harpsichordist decides to do a crazy tuning, I can move them around to go with the harpsichord. She's not too crazy today, so they look kind of straight. As you probably noticed, I hold the bow wrong, but it's right. It's called underhand, and it's very good for chordal playing, which you'll see now. It's not so good for short notes, but that's how they were held, that's how they were bowed, so that's how we decided to do it when we started playing the old instruments again. These are both copies. There's nothing very old. All this is now 40 years old this year. And this is actually older than that. So they are played a lot in Europe. So when I was living in Europe, I had some people make me a lot of instruments. So this is a copy of a Viennese instrument from the 14th century, or is it 15th, I think. And this is a 17th century copy, of a 17th century French instrument. So the pieces I'm playing by Hume will be played on the small viol.